Octet rule and ion formation. The noble gases are found here on the very right-hand side of the periodic table. Noble gases are very stable. They're unreactive, very happy the way they are. And we believe it's the number of electrons in their outermost shell that conveys that stability. With the exception of helium, all of the other noble gases have 8 outermost electrons. And that's given rise to what's called the octet rule. We believe that elements tend to gain or lose electrons to achieve 8 outermost electrons. In other words, they'd all like to be like the noble gases. And that helps us explain the reactivity of all of the elements up here in the periodic table. Let's look at chlorine, element number 17, for example. Chlorine is pretty close to the noble gas argon. Argon has 18 total electrons. Chlorine has 17. If it had just one more, it would be very similar to the electronic structure of argon. Or if we look at it in terms of valence shell electrons, chlorine is in group 7A. It has 7 valence electrons. It'd like to have one more. And so what we see is that chlorine and its reactions tends to add an electron to become a Cl minus. That is to say, it becomes an ion. It's an atom now with a charge on it. Because electrons are negatively charged, if we add an electron to an electrically neutral atom, the result is that we'll have an atom with a charge on it. And that's true not only of chlorine, but bromine and iodine and fluorine. They'd all like to add one more electron so that they resemble the noble gas to their immediate right. Or if we back up one column and look at oxygen. Oxygen is in group 6A. It has 6 valence electrons. It'd like to have 8. So oxygen in its reactions tends to add 2 electrons. In other words, to become an O2 minus. And that's true of sulfur and selenium and tellurium, all the elements in that column. If we look at element number 11, sodium, sodium has 11 total electrons, but it's in column 1A, so it has 1 valence shell electron, and it'd like to have 8 outermost electrons. Well, it could gain 7 and be like argon, but 7 is an awfully big number of electrons to gain, or if it lost 1, then it's back to the noble gas configuration of neon. So it's easier for sodium to lose 1 than it is to gain 7. So sodium in its reactions tends to give up an electron and to become Na+, an ion, a positively charged ion. And that's true of lithium, potassium, and rubidium, and so on. All of the elements in this column have 1 outermost electron. They all tend to form a plus 1 ion. Those elements in group 2 have 2 valence shell electrons. It's easy for them to give up those 2 and to become a 2 plus element. We'll skip this intersection and these elements down here. They're all metals. They all like to give up electrons, but it's hard for us to predict what these elements in the center and down here will do. But we can make a prediction when we get to group 3A. Using aluminum as an example, aluminum's in group 3A, means that it has 3 electrons in the valence shell. Aluminum could be like argon if it gained 5. Or if it lost 3, it could be like neon. And losing 3 is easier. So aluminum in its reactions tends to form a 3 plus ion, indicating that it's given up 3 electrons. Those elements in group 4A, well, 4 is exactly halfway. They could gain 4 or they could lose 4, but 4 is a large number. And those elements in group 4A tend not to transfer electrons. They like to share electrons to form covalent bonds, and we'll talk about those later. Let's look at nitrogen in group 5A. Well, if it gained three electrons, it'd be like neon. So nitrogen and the elements in group 5A like to form a 3- ion to take on three electrons. We mentioned the elements in 6A form a 2-, those in 7A form a 1-, over here in 8A, hey, they're happy the way they are. Let's see if we can summarize. To summarize, we'll be able to predict ion formation in two areas of the periodic table, here on the left and on the right, because we're able to pinpoint the number of valence electrons in these columns. And furthermore, now we've gone through some of the elements in each of these areas, and we see that the elements in group 1A like to form a 1+, a 2+. We skip the center section, over here a 3+, and we're skipping group 4A. They tend not to transfer electrons. 3-, 2-, 1-, and of course group 8A is happy the way it is. Knowing this, being able to predict ion formation, you know a tremendous amount of chemistry. Now, just based upon the periodic chart, let's see if we can pick a couple of elements in practice. Calcium is element number 20, has 20 total electrons, but two valence shell electrons. And if we were to predict what calcium would like to do, it would give up two electrons to form a 2+ ion because it's in group 2A. Or if we picked, let's look at phosphorus, element 15. It's over here, it's a little closer to the noble gases, so it's easier for phosphorus to gain electrons than it is to give them up. And it's in group 5A, it needs three more electrons to be like argon, so phosphorus is going to form a 3- ion.